Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a quite new model from Kizer Knives, and it is going to be the Guru, a really, really interesting new model from Kizer in collaboration with the custom knife maker Matt Degnan. And this model actually came out with Kizer in four different models. So here you can see I have the Thumbstud deploying model with the holes in the titanium frame. There is also a model like this, but just without the holes. And then there are two flipper models, one without the holes and one with the holes. And I believe they don't have the Thumbstuds then. So three different models of the same knife. All the materials are all the same. Titanium frame lock, S35VN steel. And this knife is based on Matt Degnan's MC model, which was dedicated to his mentor in knife making, Matt Cucciara. That is also why it is called the MC model. And because he was like his knife guru or knife mentor, this knife is called the Guru. So very interesting story here behind this knife, and also a very, very interesting knife in my opinion. But now let's take a look at the specs of this knife as always. So we have an overall length here of 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3 inches or 7.6 centimeters. But you have a forward choil right here. So the actual cutting edge is more like 2.75 inches or 7 centimeters. And then the blade thickness is a quite sturdy 3.5 millimeters. Here you can also see the name of the designer, Matt Degnan. And of course, this knife is also part of the Bladesmith series by Kizer. Then we have a handle length here on this knife of 4.5 inches or 11.4 centimeters. So overall, a really nice EDC sized knife for me personally. Fits my hand that are small to medium really well. You can also use the forward finger choil like this, which also feels very nice in hand. Just a nice EDC friendly knife with a 3-inch blade. So really up my alley. But now let's take a look at the weight of this knife. And it weighs 112 grams or 3.95 ounces. So just under 4 ounces for a 3-inch full titanium knife is a little bit much, but still manageable for me. I haven't found this to drag my pockets down or anything like that. But it certainly is heavier than some of its competition, even with the holes. I would think that the full titanium handled version will be even heavier. But that is of course the case, because other than the holes there was no skeletonizing done here on this titanium handle scale. And of course the blade thickness is even a little bit too much for me. I would like to see, especially for a knife of this size, a thickness that was around 3 millimeters or something like that. So that is certainly something that is going to add to the weight. But overall it is still under 4 ounces and quite easy to carry, so it's not that big of a deal. But a slightly lighter version of the Guru would be much appreciated. Now let's take a closer look at the 3-inch blade here on this knife. And you can see you have a very interesting and unique sheep's foot style blade that really attracted me to this knife. Very, very good looking. And then you have a flat grind from a little bit higher than halfway up the blade, which is a little bit of a miss in my opinion. I would like to see a hollow grind on this knife or a higher flat grind. So that is certainly a little bit of a negative, because you have a quite thick blade stock and then a quite shallow flat grind right there. So it's going to be a little bit thicker behind the edge, but they actually managed to choose a really nice angle. So it's not that thick behind the edge, but I would still like to see a hollow grind here on the Guru. One thing that they have done really nicely is the sharpening choil that also functions as your forward finger choil, so you can easily sharpen the whole edge of the blade right there. But because the handle of the Guru is actually quite enough for my hands and for most hands, I would think, I would like to see if they just would pull back the cutting edge to here and just leave out the finger choil. I would think that would be a more useful approach to the overall design. But as it is right now, it is a functional finger choil, so that is just a personal preference. Other than that, you can see you have here on your blade a nice satin finish, but I really like a stonewash finish on my blade, even though this satin finish really contrasts nicely with the bead blasted handle. But I personally would like to see a stonewash blade here on this knife. And then you have your Kizer markings. Here we have the Kizer logo and then the steel choice as well as the model number. On the other side, you have only the model name, nice and discreet here behind the thumb stud, and on the spine of the blade, you have the marking for the designer Matt Degnan. So overall, quite understated logos, pretty well done here in my opinion, and I really like the overall blade shape here, very, very useful in EDC use, and it came very, very sharp out of the box, really impressive. And the steel that they use is of course S35VN, a very well-known high-end steel, powder metallurgy, nice fine grain structure, very corrosion resistant, and a really nice edge retention and also quite tough. So overall, really nice steel choice, especially in the price range of these knives. Now let's take a look at the handle construction and design. And you can see here that you have very flowing lines, a nice 3D contour titanium handle scale here, with a gorgeous bead blast finish that I actually really like on titanium handles. But of course it is going to be quite susceptible to scratches. You can see here around the holes I have some scratches. Here it looks quite nice. Here around the hole and the back screw right there. And then here in the front from putting it into the pocket on the pocket clip itself. So there are certainly some nail trails on there, but it is still quite durable in my opinion, so it's not going to scratch up right away and very, very readily, but you certainly are going to see some snail trails when you're using and carrying this knife. But I really like the feel of it, so the a little bit rougher feel on the titanium scales here is something that I really like. And you can also see that the hole pattern that you can choose on these knives is done really nicely with some chamfer on the inside, so no sharp edges or corners or anything like that. And you can also see that shiny satin finish blade through there that contrasts really nicely with the bead blasted titanium finish. And this bead blast finish is something you don't see that often from Kizer. Normally their knives are finished in a finish that looks a little bit like that, so a little bit a finer bead blast, or I'm not quite sure how I should call that, but I really like this finish much more than this kind of more silvery finish on the Ursa Minor, for example. So really a big fan of the finish here, and also the ergonomics on these knives are done extremely, extremely well. Very, very comfortable in the hand. Sometimes if I grip it really hard, you can see here the cutout on the titanium lock bar has a little bit of a nose right here, and that can dig into your finger a little bit, but it was not that big of an issue as I had anticipated. But you can also see that the titanium handle scales are nicely rounded and contoured. Really nice 3D milling here that makes this knife a very, very comfortable knife in your hand. No hot spots on this knife except for this little nose here at the titanium lock bar cutout. You can also see that your steel insert serves as your over travel stop right here, and you have your two screws that hold that in place. Here you can take a look at the lockup of the knife as well, with the steel insert, very well done. Then here you can see that you have a nice cutout on the presentation scale and a slight chamfer on the lock bar, so it's really easy to disengage the lock bar and close that knife up. That is certainly a really nice thing as well. And then you have your standard slightly decorative Kizer hardware with your pivot screw, which is Torx, and your one body screw in the back. It is also a flow-through construction with just one standoff in the back, so really easy to clean out there. Your lock bar cutout is on the outside. I would like to see it on the inside, especially on a knife that is nicely contoured and rounded like that. So that could be improved in a future version. And then the pocket clip on this knife is done really well. You have a 3D milled titanium pocket clip here that certainly have enough spring tension right there, but still is quite easy to put in and out of your pocket, so really well executed. And it is slightly different than on your Ursa Minor. You can see it's a little bit broader and not as long, so very nice clip, I have to say. You also have your lanyard hole here in the back, and the clip is going to carry around like this in your pocket, as you're going to see by the inlaid picture. One thing I would like to see is a slightly longer blade. As you can see here, there is a lot of room left here, and that is of course because of the lanyard hole. So even with the landed hole, it could be slightly longer, but I would actually like to see the lanyard hole removed and shorten the handle, or just leave the handle as it is, fill up the lanyard hole and just extend the blade a little bit. So that is just my personal preference. If you like a lanyard, you certainly will appreciate the lanyard hole right there. I would also like to see if they had chamfered the lanyard hole in the same fashion as they have done with these holes right here, just to give it a more uniform overall look. Here we can also take a look at the centering, which is really nicely done, perfect centering, and also the standoff is quite nice looking, really nice polished standoff right there. Then let's take a look at the action of this knife. So here you have your standard Kizer ceramic ball bearing system and detent, and that certainly makes this knife an extremely smooth knife, and that coupled with the quite heavy 3.5mm blade makes this knife a extremely smooth knife. As you can see here, it's nearly self-closing. The detent is also very nicely dialed in. Maybe I can show you that here. And there is nearly absolutely no friction in that pivot, so that really impressed me. This is certainly the most smooth knife from Kizer that I have so far. Very impressive what they achieved here on the Kizer Guru. Really smooth knife, and I'm very happy that I went with the Thumbstud deploying option on this knife, because there are not a lot of that smooth ball bearing pivot Thumbstud opening knives on the market, and I think the Guru is certainly one of the best out there. Very impressed with the action. Really well done. You can see absolutely free falling, still no side to side play, no up and down play, just absolutely perfect. One thing that I also like is that actually here where the flipper tab would be on the other versions, they have nicely and flushly finished the tang of the blade with the handle. That just makes for a really good look. I would like to see some jimping here on the spine of the blade where you have your Matt Degnan name, but because of that they certainly could not do the jimping, but a little bit of jimping here on an otherwise quite slick knife would be a nice additional traction spot. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. I now had it for about 3 months, and I really enjoyed carrying this knife. It was one of my favorite EDC knives in that period of time, and it came very sharp from Kizer. Very impressive, razor sharp, really easy to shave some hair, and it still is very sharp. And that is quite an achievement on a knife that has such a thick blade stock. And you can see it slices paper without any problem, even after 3 months of EDC rotation and regular EDC tasks like opening letters, packages, food preparation, and things like that. Also cutting some cardboard, and it's just a joy to use. I'm a big fan of the S35VN that Kizer uses, and also this blade shape totally spoke to me. And also the satin finish has held up quite nicely. I only have one scratch. I hope I can show you that. Here in the middle of the flat part right here, there is a little bit of pronounced scratch here on the blade. Other than that, still a really nicely looking satin finish here. And the blade shape is just so useful in an EDC environment, like a Warncliffe blade. And you still have quite a nice tip here on that sheep's foot blade, as you can see here. So really nicely executed here on blade shape sharpening and heat treating on this S35VN steel. Now let's come to the size comparisons that I like to do. And first off is a knife that you have seen a couple of times during this review, and it is of course the Kizer Ursa Minor. A really nice design from Ray Laconico and Kizer Knives. Very good looking. It also features the nice 3D contour titanium handle scales and some really nice blue anodized hardware as well. Milled titanium clip and the same S35VN steel blade. And size wise those two are very similar overall. You can see here same blade size, nearly identical handle size as well, and of course both of them feature the ceramic ball bearing system of Kizer. And this is probably one of the best Kizer flippers that I have, so they really are getting better and better with every new model. And here you can also see the nice stonewash finish that they have on the blade, and I would like to see that finish on the Kizer Guru as well. So really nice knife here. Also, I previously reviewed on the channel the Kizer Ursa Minor. The next comparison that I have for you is a US made knife, and it is actually the Southern Grind Spider Monkey. Very, very similar in the overall size, same steel. This one is made in the US and has some gorgeous carbon fiber handle scales, and is also considerably lighter than the Guru, but size-wise very, very similar. But here you can see you have pretty much the identical blade length, but you just get a quarter of an inch more cutting edge because you don't have this forward troil, which is in my opinion not really necessary because you have enough room here on the nicely contoured handle. So I would like to see additional cutting edge on the Guru and just get rid of the forward finger troil, but that is of course just a personal preference. Really great knife here. I love to carry that around. Very good EDC here from Southern Grind, and previously reviewed on the channel as well. And the last comparison I have for you is going to be the Sebenza 21. Small version here with micarta inlays, same steel as well. And here you can see the size comparisons. The small Sebenza is a little bit smaller overall here in the blade as well as in the handle, but you can see you have a very similar finish here on the handle scales, and it's just an awesome knife. I love my small Sebenza here, pretty much my perfect EDC knife. Love the finish on that handle, and of course my micarta inlays put it absolutely over the top. And here I also have the Insingo blade shape, which is a little bit reminiscent of the Guru's blade shape here, so they have that in common, but the overall shape of the Sebenza is a little bit more streamlined. You also have some jimping here, which I really like. Just an awesome knife, and probably my favorite knife overall in my collection so far. But you can see, if you have a Sebenza, that those two are quite similar. The Guru is slightly larger. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. And if you want to get yourself your own Kizer Guru, you're going to pay around $180, depending on where you're getting it. You will find a link to my recommended retailer in the description below, which is of course White Mountain Knives, great international shipping, and also a really great guy to deal with. And I think for that amount of money, you're really getting one of the best Kizer knives I have ever handled. Really great design, loving the blade shape. Awesome, awesome action here. Ceramic ball bearings and detent. Of course, $180 are quite a bit of money for a knife, but if you're looking into these high-end knives, you will see that Kizer really provides quite a bit of value. So if you're interested in a Kizer knife, I would highly recommend to check out the Kizer Guru line, and I would actually recommend it over the Ursa Minor right here, as well as the Gemini. There are some little things that put me a little bit off. I would like to see a slightly thinner blade stock, also no forward finger troil, and a stone-washed blade finish. But those are pretty much little nitpicks. A hollow grind would also be a nice feature if you want to keep your 3.5mm of blade stock. But overall, I think it's an awesome, awesome EDC folder. It is just under 4 ounces and has a good overall size and an awesome blade shape for EDC tasks. So certainly one of my favorites from Kizer so far. And this was my review of the Kizer Guru. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.